everybody, it's Jamie from Frickin Fraggin. Today I wanted to show you my Pom Pom Crab, also known as the Boxer Crab. Its Hawaiian name is Kumimi Pua, meaning inedible flower crab. Here is the species, phylum, and family. Now they call this the Pom Pom Crab because it carries around a sea anemone in each claw. The anemones look like tiny pom-poms or boxer gloves. So these crabs are very interesting because it is the first known case of an animal stimulating another to reproduce asexually, and I'll tell you how. The crab carries around two anemones, one for each claw. If they lose their anemones, they will often steal one from another crab. Then they take the one anemone and rip it apart to have a fragment in each claw. Within a few days, the fragments will regenerate into clones of the original. Pretty cool. They believe these stinging anemones help to ward off predators. The crab and anemone have formed a symbiotic relationship. The anemone benefits, too, by being protected and probably gets to absorb more food particles by being carried around. Now, if they don't have any anemone to carry around, they will find something. They are known to use pieces of sponges, zoas, and corals. Now, these crabs aren't considered a bad hitchhiker, and because they are very colorful and interesting, most aquarium hobbyists will purchase them from online vendors. They can go for about $27, and I've seen them go up to about $50. They aren't considered bad hitchhikers and are reef friendly. The pom-pom crab pictured here is a saltwater breed, and there are freshwater pom-poms as well. These crabs like a water salinity range of 1.020 to 1.025, an alkalinity of 8 to 12, and a pH of 8.1 to 8.4. There are 10 known species out there, and if you spot something red on your crab's abdomen, don't worry. They are tiny red eggs, which they carry for 13 to 15 days. When the eggs are developed, they will release them into the water column. Pom-pom crab here is considered to have an easy care level, a peaceful temperament. They are reef compatible with caution because they are omnivores and also scavengers. Most scavengers are opportunistic eaters, but it would be beneficial to feed it some meaty foods, which it will mop up with the anemones. It will also use its anemones to filter planktons and other particulates. I have found these guys to be great for nano tanks, especially because of their small size. Mine usually comes out when the lights are off or dim. Their lifespan is about a year, and like most inverts, when they grow, they will molt their outer shell. So don't be scared if you find their molt in your tank and think your crab has passed. He's still in there with a nice brand new suit. Their max size is 1 inch. They originated in Hawaii and Indonesia. These guys are just so cool to watch. They wave their little anemones around and can be a great part of your cleanup crew. They will eat whatever is found appetizing on the rocks or in the substrate. Always make sure it has compatible tank mates and is properly acclimated before introducing to your aquarium. Well, that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed watching our little pom-pom crab named Gizmo. And if you have any questions or comments, leave them below in the comment section. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, thanks for watching. I'm just waving my hands in my tank. I love when people watch me. Now where's my food?